Hi children, good morning to one and all. This is Sudharani. In this class, we are going to discuss about the topic is green plants. The topic is green plants. What is meant by green plants? In general, if you observe, all the plants are in which color? Green color. All the plants are in which color? Green color. Why do all the plants are in green color? Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. Okay. The why all the plants are in green color means they prepare their own food. The plants which prepare their own food generally are in green color. How they will prepare their own food? They prepare their own food by using photosynthesis process. All the plants are in green color due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. Due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. Okay. They prepare their own food by using photosynthesis. They prepare their own food by using photosynthesis process. In general, we can see the non-green plants also. They are moles and mushrooms. Generally, moles and mushrooms are non-green plants. They can't prepare their own food. So, they will eat dead and rotten matter. If you see a parts of a leaf. The parts of the leaves are number 1, veins, number 2, leaf blade, number 3, leaf stalk. Okay. Here we see generally we can see different types of leaves. All the leaves are not in same shape. Okay. They have different. They will be reticulate, parallel. We can see different types of leaves. Mango trees are leaves are different. Neem trees are different. Banana trees, banyan trees, rose flowers. Different types of plants and different types of leaves. But all of them are green plants. All of them can prepare their own food. Okay. Here first one. Veins. Vein is nothing but a thin, thin needle like structure is there, which is called veins. Again, veins are of two types. One is midrib, second one is side veins. Midrib means the tube like structure running through leaf is called midrib. Okay, the thin tube like structure running towards the leaf is called midrib, and the veins present in the leaves is called side veins. Okay, they are called side veins. Next, leaf blade means the flat structure of a leaf. The flat structure of a leaf is called leaf blade. Next, what is meant by stalk? The line which is connecting the leaf and stem. Leaf and stem is called stalk. Must see the leaf structure and the parts. Leaf blade and veins, midrib, stalk and side veins. Okay. Next, stomata. what is meant by stomata? But generally, how we will breathe? We will breathe through our lungs. We will breathe oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Okay, how the fish will breathe? Fish will breathe through their lungs. Fish will breathe through their lungs. The air present in water they will observe. Okay, in general we can say frog, snake, all the insects, all the living organisms should breathe. Okay, they will breathe through their lungs or gills or some other pores present on. Frog means it can breathe through lungs or it can breathe through the pores present on their body. In the same way, since plants are also living things, they should also breathe. How they will breathe? They will breathe through the tiny pores present on the leaves. Tiny pores present on the leaves, which is called stomata. Which is called stomata. If we observe any dry leaves, if you keep one leaf in your book and see after 10 or 15 days, you can see the layer of the green color will disappear and we can see a ash color leaf. In that we can see the net-like structure, in which it contains tiny pores. The leaf will breathe through tiny pores present on it, which are called stomata. In the stomata, the exchange of gases will take place. The leaf will absorb carbon dioxide gas and release oxygen. What is the function of a leaf? Generally, we call leaf as a kitchen of the plant. Why we call leaf a kitchen of the plant? Because leaf prepare the food for the plants. Who will prepare food for the plants? Leaf. Leaf will prepare food for the plant. So it is called kitchen of the plant. So leaf is called kitchen of the plant. Why it is called kitchen of the plant? Because it prepares food. How it will prepare the food? It prepares the food by using air, water and sunlight. By preparing the food by air, water and sunlight. Okay. The preparation of the food by using air, water and sunlight is called photosynthesis. Is called photosynthesis. It prepares the food in the form of a glucose. In the form of a glucose. The plants will prepare their food in the form of a glucose. And the store the food, their food in the form of a starch. Starch and a ganji. Okay, starch product. If you cut a potato, you will see a white color, which is called starch. Okay, see again. What is the function of the leaf, ma? Leaf prepare the food for the plants. Okay, so leaf is called kitchen of the plant. Kitchen of the plant. How it will prepare its food? By using photosynthesis. What is meant by photosynthesis? The preparation of the food by using air, water and sunlight. Okay. It gets sunlight from chlorophyll. It gets sunlight from chlorophyll. And it gets air from stomata. It gets air from stomata. And water from the root. By using this air, water and sunlight, the leaf will prepare the food by using photosynthesis.